Okay, so for this recipe, you are going to be taking 2 sticks of butter, which is 1 cup, and I'm just unwrapping it here, and I'm going to put it in the microwave for 30-second intervals to melt it all the way, and then I'm going to put it in my big mixing bowl. And then you're going to add 2 cups of sugar to the butter. And then you're going to take your vanilla and you're going to add 1 teaspoon of it to a small bowl. And then you're going to take 2 eggs and you're going to crack it into another bowl, a little bigger this time. And in the end, you're going to put all the ingredients into the big mixing bowl with the butter and the sugar. And then you're going to add 2 cups of flour. Then take your unsweetened cocoa powder and add 1/2 cup of it to the mixing bowl, and you're just going to mix the flour and the cocoa powder together. So this is totally optional, but if you want, you can add 1 cup of chocolate chips. If you want more of a gooey kind of taste and more chocolatey taste, then I would recommend of chocolate chips. Then take some pan spray and just lightly spray your pan. It's going to be a 9x13 inch pan, and I'm just going to place all my batter into the pan and smoothing it out. So once the brownies have baked and cooled, you're going to take some hard cookie cutters and just cut out the brownies, and you might need to use a spatula to help you get them out of the pan, and then put them on a separate pan to the side with parchment paper. All the brownies in the heart form, and I think they all look really cute. They were a little bit thick, so I probably would have used a larger pan to thin out the layer. So for the cheesecake filling in the middle, I'm going to add 2 8-ounce packages of cream cheese, and this is from Laura Vitale's recipe for a no-bake chocolate cheesecake, and I'll put the link down below. But if you want more in-depth information, definitely go to that website or that video, and it's really easy to make though, and we're not going to be chilling it, so it's not going to take 3 hours, so that's really great about this recipe. To that, you are going to add 2 tablespoons of milk, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, and 1/2 cup of brown sugar and regular granulated sugar. So there's your completed brownie. These tasted amazing. They were so good, so rich, and a lot of my friends loved them, and they were very popular. So thank you guys so much for watching, and leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and I'll see you later. Bye!